Hello, we are going to talk about the dendritic spine, a neuroelectric compartment of neurons. These are dendritic spines. Here, they are opposing one to each other. And we can see that dendritic spines can be in all kind of dendrites. The basal dendrites can have dendritic spines, the main apical dendrites, the secondary dendrites can also have spines, and the tuft. The dendritic tuft can have several spines also. The general structure of a dendritic spine is this. We have a head with a diameter of about 1000 nanometers. We have a neck of about 70 nanometers of diameter. And we have a neck 150 nanometers in length. The separation between the spine and the connection with other neuron, the axon, is about 20 nanometers. This is important if we consider that the main electrical carrier of the spine, which is calcium ions, is very small, is about 0.1 nanometers or about 1 angstrom. The head contains these structures, the endoplasmatic reticulum, where it is believed some new proteins can be locally generated, proteins that can modify the interaction with the axons or can modify the architecture, the structure of the whole dendrite. For instance, in yellow, we have actin, one of the more dynamic proteins that are scaffold proteins. They can connect crossing the space between the contact of neurons and be linked with another actin proteins in the axon. Because actin is very dynamic, we can imagine that the architecture of the spine is also very dynamic. We can have spines with a long neck only and not head at all, or a very small head. We can have well-developed spines with head and neck, as the one we show here. These are the more stable and, let's say, successful architecture. This is a stubby dendrite with only a sort of head, but without a neck. We can also find dendritic spines that have a common neck and two small heads, like in a bifurcation. We can also find different spines in the tuft. Some of them information in evolution. So all these different shapes suggest that the dendritic spines go through a different stages according to the stimulation they receive from other neurons. Spines can be considered like calcium-based memory devices. because when an action potential arrives from other neuron, calcium goes into the spine, and it can be stored in the inner space, or can be stored also in the endoplasmatic reticulum. It can go to the spine neck and continue with the parent dendrite toward the nucleus, where it can influence the chemical activities of the whole cell. But because almost all of the compartments of the neurons are electrically sensitive, the dendritic spine can react also to the electrical activity in the dendrites. Interesting combination of signals can occur when some signals arrive from the axon, from other neurons, and when local signals coincide with these signals coming from the neuron itself. As we can imagine, this is a very delicate and dynamic structure that can change in a matter of minutes and seconds and evolve through all these types and shapes. When they are measured, the small recording devices can affect the way these spines react. These geometric measures can give us a good idea about how calcium ions, which are about 1 angstrom or 0.1 nanometer, can go through these structures to his travel to other parts of the neuron. If you like this video, please subscribe. Thank you for your attention.